Hello and welcome to Sportuccino. I'm Richard Parr. You're watching on Facebook, YouTube, and at sportuccino.com. It's so good to have you with us. And of course, if you're listening back to this or as a podcast on iTunes and Stitcher, welcome to you as well. And of course, every single Wednesday, we are talking about professional wrestling. Yes, it is my passion. So I thought on Sportuccino, we'll do a whole show about wrestling. Why not? It's my show. I can do what I want. Of course, we've had some great interviews recently with Al Snow and Rockstar Spud, and I've got an amazing guest coming up for you on today's program. Just before we get to him, I want to tell you about 99 Designs. 99 Designs helped design the Sportuccino logo. It's pretty cool, isn't it? And you too can have something designed by them as well. Maybe it's a poster or a flyer or a website or your own logo. Go and check out 99 Designs. I've got a link to them on this Facebook and this YouTube page. And of course, if you do use their service, you will be supporting Sportuccino. And if you're not happy with their service, they offer a money-back guarantee. So go and check out 99 Designs. All right, I'm now delighted to say that joining me on Sportuccino today is the five-star wrestling champion, John Morrison. John, welcome to the program. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great, bro. Thanks for having me.
It's great to have you on the program, John. Wanted to get you on this show for a while. So why don't you start off by telling us about five-star wrestling? And of course, you're the champion as well. And there's a big event coming up, and there's a lot of people gunning for your title, isn't there?
Absolutely. I mean, I've been at every five-star wrestling show since the promotion began, seen it grow and turn into what it is now. And what's happening now is five-star wrestling is putting on the biggest tournaments in wrestling history. It starts June 10th in Liverpool and carries on weekly throughout different cities all throughout the UK. And yes, I happen to be the five-star wrestling champion, and there's a very talented roster with people like Rob Van Dam, Rey Mysterio, Carlito, El Ligaro, gunning for the five-star wrestling championship. So if I want to keep it, I got my work cut out for me. And I couldn't be more excited for the tournament, all the people that are in the tournament, and the opportunity to travel throughout the UK.
Yeah, the UK is a really hot scene right now, John. What makes Five Star different to some of the other British promotions, do you think?
Well, see, Five Star Wrestling for sure has the best champion of any wrestling force in the UK. every promotion is different. I mean, what Dan's done with Five Star is he's created this global phenomenon of a promotion, pulling people in from every different wrestling background all over the world, and putting on this tournament on live TV is a little bit nuts. It's a little bit crazy. It's a very big goal, and I think that's one of the things that makes Five Star different. Dan's vision is for this huge promotion that's it's trying to do the biggest tournament in wrestling history. And everything that he's tried to do, he's accomplished. And I think his vision for what he wants out of this promotion and the talent that he's got involved are what create Five Star Wrestling and give it its identity.
And is that one of the things you enjoy about being on the independent scene now, John? Is obviously, you were in WWE, you had a really good career there. And yet, by being in the independent scene, you get to try all these different promotions, and you're working with people who are really passionate about what they do and really have dreams. Does it excite you when you meet people like Dan and probably other promoters who are like, we're going to try this, we're going to try something new?
Absolutely. I mean, everybody in wrestling is a little bit nuts. I'm a little bit nuts. But it's one of the cool things about doing what we do. And as far as being excited about being involved in independent wrestling, yeah, I mean, I think that is one of the coolest things. The people that are working with Five Star Wrestling are doing that because they want to, because they're excited about wrestling, because they're excited about doing new things and being on shows that have never happened before and wrestling opponents that they may never have wrestled before. So all those things are, to me, what makes me so excited about doing this.
So in your 5 years now as an independent wrestler, what's been the craziest match you've been in? As you say, everyone's a bit nuts.
Oh man, it's always tough to hone in on the one craziest match. I mean, through Five Star Wrestling, I had the opportunity to work AJ Styles before he signed with the Fed, and have a really cool match with him that meant a lot to me. And but as far as craziest matches go, I mean, wrestling at the Gathering of the Juggalos is up there among the craziest. Getting pelted with Fago at the Gathering was nuts. A lot of the stuff that I've been doing with AAA has been crazy. Sometimes I think it's still real to them in Mexico, which is cool. And the energy from the crowds in the UK is I think part of the reason wrestling is so hot in the UK right now, and why I like going over to your country so much. It's every crowd has its own soccer chants and different ways of appreciating and viewing a wrestling match, and it makes it really cool for someone like me.
Yeah, we certainly are passionate when it comes to our wrestling. And you mentioned AJ Styles there, and you had a good time working with him. Who do you think you've had the best chemistry with throughout your career?
It's tough to that, like, again, like, best chemistry is a pretty like ultimate question and statement.
That's what we do here at Sportuccino, John. Ultimate questions and statements.
Everything has got to be the main. It's tough. Guys like Jeff Hardy, Rey Mysterio, CM Punk, Ricochet, Willie Mack, Cage, Phoenix, and Pentagon. In my opinion, a lot of the best wrestling that I've done in my career is been for independent promotions like Five Star Wrestling and Lucha Underground. I think my wrestling game has really leveled up over the past couple of years. And the stuff that I'm capable of now, I couldn't do 5 or 10 years ago. So a lot of my favorite matches have been recent matches.
Okay. Is that just because you're more experienced now, or is it because you've got to a point in your career where almost any promoter can say, you have complete creative license, you can do whatever you want, and you really enjoy that and grasp it with both hands?
Both of those things, yes. But a big part of it is actually has a little bit to do with the movie that you mentioned, Boone the Bounty Hunter. And not just that movie, but everything that I've been doing since I left my full-time schedule with WWE. But for this movie, for Boone the Bounty Hunter, before we started shooting this movie, I trained parkour and stunt choreo pretty rigorously for a year and a half, like 2 or 3 days a week, hitting like a parkour gym in the morning for a couple hours. And what that did for me was it made me look at parkour and pro wrestling and stunt choreo in a different way. And it unlocked a lot of my movement skills that I hadn't fully mastered before, especially as far as twisting and flipping and ideas to create entries and exits into entries and exits is what I would say you have to do in stunt choreo in TV or a film if you want to get a wrestling move like a Canadian Destroyer or a Hellevator or a Powerbomb in a TV show or a film. You need more of an entry or an exit than you would need for doing the same type of move in a wrestling match just based on the pacing. But all the training that I've done for those things has unlocked the way that I look at pro wrestling and my physical capabilities as well. And I think that plus the other two things you mentioned are why I feel like my best work is happening right now.
That's incredible. And in fact, I think you'd be interested to see a previous episode we've done here on Sportuccino on our sports business show, where we spoke to Sebastian Foucan, who's one of the real pioneers of parkour. And he was also in the opening scene of Casino Royale, you might remember, when he's been chased by Daniel Craig.
That was one of the that was one of the biggest parkour chase scenes that brought parkour really into pop culture to the mainstream. For sure. How could I forget that?
Yeah, you'll have to go check that out. It was a really good chat with Sebastian. So tell us more about Boone the Bounty Hunter.
Okay. So Boone the Bounty Hunter is a movie that I am a writer, producer, and the star of. It's about a bounty hunter who does a combination of parkour, pro wrestling, and brawler MMA style moves to Boone delinquent celebrities like Kevin Sorbo. But when his reality show is going to get canceled, Boone decides to take his crew, Spencer Grammer from Rick and Morty and Greek, Osric Chow from Supernatural, and Rampage Jackson from the A-Team and the UFC, down to Mexico to go after a real criminal to spike ratings. But things get complicated in Mexico, and now you've got this goofy reality show bounty hunter Boone, who's a bit naive, up against a real drug cartel, and Boone has to figure out what's more important, saving his show or his friends. And ultimately what you get is a really fun action movie with tons of one-liners and cool action that I'm really stoked about. It's out on all the VOD platforms right now in the United States: Amazon, iTunes, Vudu, Xbox, Vimeo, etc. And I don't really know when it's going to be out in the UK, but I've been discussing potentially having some screenings over in the UK in different cities, possibly in conjunction with Five Star Wrestling. And as soon as I get any info on when it's going to be released in the UK, maybe we should talk again.
Yeah, I'd love for you to let us know when that happens and we can get you on Sportuccino, and maybe we can come down and cover that as well. That would be fantastic. I've seen the trailer. It looks that great combination of action and comedy all in one. So I'm really looking forward to seeing it, John, whenever it is in the UK. Obviously, people will always look at wrestling and acting, and they'll look at people like The Rock, Batista, even going back to Hulk Hogan. Have you spoken to any of them about your movie before you started the process?
I know those guys, Rock, Batista, John Cena. Before I started wrestling, I was a film major at university at UC Davis out here, and made a bunch of action shorts, and even wrote, directed, produced, and starred and edited a feature film while I was still in school. It's been something that I've been wanting to do. I grew up on pro wrestling and action movies, and those have been my two dreams. So it's something that's been kicking around in my head since I was a kid, and I feel like I've really been self-motivated as far as the reason why I wanted to do this movie.
Did I see also that it was film and geology you studied?
Yeah.
So when is the geology coming into your life again, John?
Well, I kind of switched. When I was going to school, I don't know why I thought this, but I kind of thought being a geologist would be kind of like being Indiana Jones in real life.
Oh, nice.
And the more I got into geology, the more I realized, I got through all the calculus, the mineralogy, and structural geology, which is really complicated. But in terms of what I kind of wanted to get into mineral exploration, and the more I learned, the more I realized it's really mathematical and scientific, which is cool. But my practice in the field in school, like geologic mapping and doing things like that, analyzing bedrock and sediments, seemed like it wasn't exactly being Indiana Jones.
Well,
and my interest was then more like I wanted to be more creative.
Well, I'm looking forward to something like Boone the Bounty Hunter 2, where it becomes more even Indiana Jones, where you're going to find some buried treasure or something like that. I think that could be a cool idea. Or not.
Oh man, I might just have to jot that down. Boone 2, sequel, Bad of the Boone.
There we go. It sounds good. All right, John, I know you've got some more interviews today, and I'm going to let you get back to them. Before we go, just give us a reminder of where we can find out more about you and also where we can find more about Five Star Wrestling, please, John.
For information about me, follow me on Twitter, at The Real Morrison, Instagram, at John Hennigan, Facebook, John Morrison. Follow Five Star Wrestling on Facebook, Twitter, and IG. And I'm going to be in Liverpool. June 10th is the first of the largest tournaments in wrestling history, traveling all over the UK. And I'm really proud and excited to be involved with this, with Five Star Wrestling. And hopefully I will see you in Liverpool if you're watching this. And if not, I'll see you when Five Star Wrestling comes to your city.
Fantastic. And of course, if you check out John on all of those social media channels, you'll also see his pretty cool belt bum bags, or you call them fanny packs, don't you?
I do. Fanny packs in the United States, although bum bags is, is I guess, how you say it in the UK, which I'm not opposed to. It's kind of fun to say bum bag.
Yeah, see, you chuckle at bum bag. We chuckle at fanny packs. So
Fanny means something different over there.
It means in the UK. Something completely different. So I think we better leave it there, John. But thank you so much for being on Sportuccino today. We look forward to seeing you defend your five-star wrestling championship. Thank you so much for being on the program.
Thanks for having me, bro. See you next time.
Really good to talk to John Morrison on Sportuccino today. It was a really good and insightful chat from the five-star wrestling champion. Of course, if you want to learn more about them, go to fivestarwrestling.co.uk. As John mentioned, they've got some amazing stars on their program. They've got people such as Rey Mysterio, Carlito, and PJ Black, among the others in the 128-man tournament. Go and check it out. All right, that's it for this week's Sportuccino Wrestling Show. We'll be back next Wednesday at sportuccino.com, Facebook, and on YouTube. We'll also be a podcast on iTunes and on Stitcher. But until then, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Goodbye for now.